Hello all, I'm Umesh Chandji Jogran, Assistant Professor at Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today we will learn about culinary history. In our previous classes, we have known and read about what is culinary sciences, the uniforms of a chef, and other basic things. In this chapter, we will be reading about the origin of cookery, from where did it started, tracing the history of cookery, birth of French cuisine, and some contributions by some renowned chefs. If we talk about the introduction part, it starts when the cooking started in the ancient times. It was just a mere discovery made by an ancient man by the method of serendipity. The fire just clicked with the attraction of two stones, or when two stones got rubbed to each other, and then a spark came and the fire generated. Similarly, nowadays people usually cook for professionally or as a hobby or a core. Now it is a very skilled line if you are choosing to become a chef, and there are endless possibilities and opportunities in the similar field. And to learn it, we have to learn about the culinary arts. In culinary history, it started with the cooking, and it is related to the cooking itself. If we have to talk about what is cooking, it is the arts of preparation of food, cooking it, and presenting it. This picture here depicts that the culinary in itself is an artist's impression. As it is mentioned, that how the things are plated in this plate, or how the different elements of a food are plated in this plate. It requires great creativity and artistry. Another term which is related to culinary history is that it is a science, and which takes place in the food, the chemical changes, the physical changes that are happening in the food while cooking it, and the transfer of heat, be it application or removal. In our earlier chapters in our earlier semester, we have read that heat transfer is done by three methods, namely conduction, convection, and radiation, about which we will discuss later. This diagram shows how the culinary arts started from its beginning, when French people claim that the French cuisine is the first professional cuisine that took birth in 1533 or in 15th century. Then came the Industrial Revolution from 17th century to 18th century, and then came the great chefs like Antoine Carême, Auguste Escoffier, who did their part of magic to the culinary and imparted the education or science behind the culinary arts. So in 17th century, or we may say after 15th century, when the kitchen used to be a large open deck or open area base kitchen where cooking was done in bulk, the French precised it or made it in a simpler version of it, or we may say that they brought their kitchens to the concised or to the closed walls, which were known as kitchen itself or a kitchen premises, where food was cooked under the hygienic conditions and the temperature was maintained, and the food was not only prepared but it was presented in such a way that it looks good to the consumers. In 16th century, when the kitchens started, it was initially known as restaurateur, or the word which came from the rotisserie itself. Restorative also means that it is a kind of soup which is made from stock, or you may say that like various stocks are required to make a soup, or are boiled again and again to restore the flavor which provide us the energy. So in 16th century, the development of food started from the restaurateur, or in the restorative manner. After that, in 18th century, again the French word restorer came into existence, which means to restore a dish or to prepare it from the beginning. This slide shows us how the French cuisine evolved, because they are usually considered to be the father of modern cuisine. It is also known as haute cuisine or nouvelle cuisine. So this word in itself was originated in 1533, and this word was given by a person named Catherine de Medici. In 17th century, the main France developed their own style of cooking and named it nouvelle cuisine, in which the more emphasis was on presentation of food, preparation of different sauces and garnishes. Cheese and wine were also a part of main dishes and usually served with the main course. Then coming to the people who did their part in developing the cuisine or in developing the modern cookery, it started with Antoine Marie Karim, who was also known as King of Chefs or the Chef of Kings. He used to cook in the different palaces or in the kitchens of different kings who were ruling in the France. He was also considered as the first celebrity chef. Father of French cuisine is his secondary name. He was the one who developed the haute cuisine, or we can say who brought up the things which brought the changes in the ancestral cuisine or ancient cuisine to bring it up to haute or modern cuisine. He developed four major sauces or four major mother sauces, which were bechamel, espagnole, velouté and allemande sauce. Then he was the one who brought up the concept of uniform to a kitchen personnel, and he himself made some changes in the chef's apron and modern day toque, also known as hat or a chef's cap. Then comes Auguste Escoffier, who is a modern day chef or who is renowned as the father of cookery. He used to work in different hotels. He never cooked in the kitchens of royalties or kitchens of kings. Instead, he chose different hotels to work in. He introduced the double-breasted chef coat, which is made in such a manner so that it doesn't get dirty easily, or it can be worn from both the sides when one side gets dirty. And he also introduced the chef hat or made some changes which were already developed by Mr. Antoine Marie Karim. He introduced the brigade system, about which we will read in our next class, which is also known as hierarchy of the kitchen. Then he is considered as the most important leader of French cuisine, as he developed it or as he brought the modern day changes, or we can say technical changes to the French cuisine. Then he codified the recipes of five mother sauces, including the four which were developed by Mr. Antoine Marie Karim. In the later stages of his life, Mr. Auguste Escoffier also wrote a book on culinary. Then coming to nouvelle cuisine or the haute cuisine, which was developed in early 70s, there were few changes which came in the French cuisine itself when Chinese traders came to France, or French traders went to China. Those changes were like variety of food was served, portions were small, then plate and presentation was the thing on which most emphasis was done by the chefs. Then fresh and prime, like expensive cuts, were used to serve the guests. Then combination of different types of cooking and different types of cuts of vegetable and different types of spices, or you may say ingredients, was introduced in the culinary of nouvelle cuisine. And in 19th century, or in the beginning of 19th century, the term modern kitchen came into existence, where the main emphasis was to modernize the kitchen and the use of different equipments, which were like use of computers in making recipes or in developing recipes, use of computers in operating different machines. Modern equipments were introduced so as to help the chefs by minimizing the time to do the mise en place. Air conditioning was also brought up in the kitchen so that a chef while cooking can cook or work in the suitable environment. Then emphasis on hygienic conditions was also introduced. So this is the last slide of our topic. In our next slide, we will be reading about classical kitchen brigade, which was introduced by Chef Antoine Marie Carême and also known as Brigade de Cuisine. Thank you. For any queries, you may reach out to me over my email ID, that is umesh.jukran@chitkara.co.in.